Welcome to another video, and today in this video we're going to be doing the rest of my survival kit or gear. As you saw in the last video, hopefully, we didn't quite look at the other one because we didn't have time, but we looked at this mini survival kit slash gear stuff, but I've just added the tinfoil in there, just so you know. And then in here we have like head torch, because I thought why not, it might need to be waterproof, but I think it is water resistant, so I just want to put it in there. And then we've got a scout knife. I just put my head torch in there because, you know, I thought might as well, and also just to keep it dry really. And then we've got a nice hat. This is not wool, by the way. Try not to use wool hats, because if they get wet, they absorb all the water and then it won't keep you warm. Because you do actually lose 40% of heat from your head. And then in here we have my knife sharpening stone. And we also have a piece of flint. It's like a stone flint. And I think that's it for that pocket, yeah. Oh wait, I've got a marker, a pen, and a stick, which I just made. Not just, but not like just now, but I did make it. So I'll just put all this stuff away, and then I'll see you in a second. Okay guys, so moving on to the next pocket, which is the biggest pocket of them all. And the last pocket of them all. We should have time to do it all. So first we've got my tinder, wild tinder, like natural. We've got all these leaves and stuff, and then we've got a sandwich bag with wood shavings. Then we've also got a light, a torch, which is currently a bit broken, but I'm gonna try and fix it. So it is quite broken. You can still turn it on, it's just a bit hard. So we've got that. Folds up quite nicely as well. Then we've also got some cotton wool balls smothered in Vaseline, which are basically really highly flammable, which is good. Also got my fire kit, and in here we have tissue paper with cotton wool inside, which is good. I think it's got more inside anyway. And then we've got flint and steel, and another bit of flint. And in here, just to give it a bit of extra waterproof, we've got a bit more tissue, makeup pads, which are cotton, oil cubes, more tissue, and then the rest is just cotton balls. So let's put all this back in. I'm going to keep that bit of tissue out just for no reason. Put them in, put them out, in, out, shake it all out. Not so much on here. Okay, so put that there. Is that it? Yep. Go on. I'm probably thinking, why don't I put these in, which are cotton wool smothered in Vaseline? It's because it won't fit, as you can see. Yeah. Then we've got a big bag of cotton balls right there. which actually sort of squashes all up, which is nice. We've got a torch, but it's a signalling torch for help and rescue. Whistle. Always good to have. Also, we've got my axe, slash multi-tool, hammer, pliers, axe, knife, screwdriver, saw, different tools, and jagged saw. So yeah, that's that. We've got a stove, which basically this just stands up really nicely like that, and then you cook whatever your CPR on babies, whatever you're cooking on there, and there's a flame underneath here and a fuel cube under here, and then the fuel cube catches fire, and then you can, you know, cook whatever you're cooking. We also have hand warmers, pretty nice, hat, army cap, and then last but not least we have two of these, just logs to get tinder off, but yeah, so that's all my survival gear so far. I've got three more items coming still. But yeah, I did get this one. But as I said, the other three other items are still coming. Which is quite annoying. But yeah, we're getting there. It's all coming slowly but surely. But yeah, so I hope you enjoyed this video. This will be part two, I think. And so, I do really hope you enjoyed this video. I'll see you guys later. Bye.